Hi everyone. Welcome to our Friday fireside. Actually, minus the fire tonight because it is, I think, about 90 degrees out here. So that's why we are here with our little water, with our fruit water, so that we can stay hydrated because it is super, super hot. So welcome. Thank you so much for spending your Friday evening with us. Grab yourself a drink, grab the kids, pull up a chair, sit by the fire with us, and enjoy the Friday evening. It's great to be at the end of the week, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Hey, good to see everybody here tonight. How are you all doing? Burning hot in Southern California today.
I'm just gonna adjust here a little
day.
Bit.
How was it out where you guys were? What did you guys do today? Let's hear it from you guys. Who got out into their gardens and worked today?
So I heard from a few people in the chat prior to the live stream that it is hot where you're at too, if you're in a southern area. I know some people are in Texas and saying it was 90 degrees there as well. It is really hot for Southern California in April. It usually doesn't get this hot until probably June or July.
This is early.
So it's really unusual. And if you saw our video earlier in the week, we posted on how to protect your vegetables from frying in the hot weather. So hopefully you're able to catch that, pick up some tips. If you're not experiencing hot weather yet, you probably will this summer, and I'm sure you will need those tips as we go through the summer months.
Yeah, and for those of you who are locals, you know this is like a dry heat already. It's already got that July, August feel to it where the air is, well, it was windy today, but it's just a dry heat. And in fact, today we were filming an episode that we're gonna post tomorrow about the heat and how Kim's plants are doing and stuff in the heat. And towards the last two shots, I started to feel really funny. And I told Kim, I said, I think I might, you know, fall here. I might faint because I just feel really, my arms and my limbs just felt just really heavy. And I just said, Kim, I think I gotta go inside. And, you know, we're like, okay, one more shot. I was like, okay, but I can't do a lot of moving on it and that kind of thing. And it was a weird, heat stroke's a weird feeling. And I don't know that I fully, you know, black out or anything like that, like you can, but I definitely was in the red line zone for sure.
Yeah, he looked really wiped out, really pale.
Yep.
Went inside, laid down on the couch. Then I grabbed a bag of riced cauliflower from the freezer and just like put that on his head, got him some water, and took you a couple of hours though to really feel back to yourself.
Yeah,
again,
really
huh?
did. And gosh, what was I going to just say about that? Yeah, I had my big straw hat that I was going to wear and I put it away. I was like, oh, I don't need the straw hat today. I'll be okay. Didn't have any water out there. And so, you know, I kind of asked for it, I guess, but yeah, it was close, but Kim took good care of me and gave me some frozen ice and stuff like that and put a picture on Instagram, you know, so I'm not looking really killer or anything in it, but I'm just kind of wiped out there. So anyway, so that was my day. What did you guys do today? Anyone get a chance to go out into your gardens? What's going on with you all? And I'm going to try and refresh my app so I can follow in the chat.
Thanks, Salvador. Heat stroke, no joke. It's a terrible feeling. Yes. So hopefully not a lot of you have experienced it, but make sure that you have water with you if you go outside in the heat. Take care of yourself first before you take care of the garden. So if you are gardening out in the heat, make sure you go out early in the morning or in the evening as it cools down. And don't risk any kind of heat stroke or dehydration. So let's see who's here in the chat. Really glad to have you guys.
April, thank you very much.
Simone from Jamaica. Hi, I'm sure you're used to a lot of heat there in Jamaica. The Moors, Amy of four is here. I'm so eager to get my plants out, but our last frost date is the 30th. It's raining in our future. Well, the 30th, believe it or not, I can't believe the 30th is next week. It's almost
That's
May.
Crazy.
So hopefully you'll be able to get your plants out soon.
Salvador, thank you very much. I got you, man. Thank you.
Lori, it's cold and windy in the 50s here in Colorado Springs. Wow. Believe it or not, I think it was in the 50s, maybe last weekend even here.
Oh, so, we were freezing earlier this week where we didn't even want to sit out back.
Right. It felt like a storm was coming in. So, yeah, it's been quite the weather switch for us here.
Yeah. Braden's typing Seattle like... What, you want us to move to Seattle? Or what are you saying about Seattle there, Mr. Braden?
Ah, Braden. Yeah, I don't think Seattle would, we'd do good in Seattle because of all the rain. So we do pretty good hail in the rain here for a few days in the summer, in the wintertime. But Seattle, I don't know about that. So what we wanted to do tonight is just kind of do some Q&A. You know, just check in with you guys, see how you're doing, see how you're holding up. It's been like a month or so, I think, since our whole stay-at-home thing started. So I want to check in with you guys, see how everybody's holding up. I know a lot of people too are homeschooling their kids, and I'm really curious to see how that's going. And if any of you are teaching your kids about gardening, because I know a lot of people said they were planning on doing that. And it's a really good excuse to get your kids outside and say, hey, this is what we're going to do for our school this week. So I would love to hear some stories from you guys if your kids are enjoying it and having fun out in the garden with you and spending some good family time together too.
So Cliff is calling up for a road trip to go to Seattle for the blackberries. All right, Cliff, you got it. Road trip it is.
Cliff was just talking in the chat earlier about the blackberries and how well they grow up there. And yeah, Cliff,
I didn't know that.
I've heard that, well, because it's so cold and wet, and we try and grow them here, and I think we do pretty good. But my sister in Oregon, she just goes out and picks them in the wild and kind of laughs that we actually have to plant them here because they grow like weeds there. So Cliff, you're on, all right?
Cliff, do you have a van? How many people can you fit in it? Let's go. Hi, Nicole Rodriguez. Good to see you here. Patty, good to see you.
Patty,
let me know when you're ready, Kim. Hey, Karen Romero, thank you very much. Glad to hear you're enjoying the show, and it's great to have you here. Friday noche. Nice.
Johnny Maserati, today it's mandatory to wear a mask in Houston. What about there?
Huh.
I believe in the city of LA, it is mandatory. Yep. We live just outside that, so it's not mandatory in our city. But yeah, I know a lot of people are doing that as well.
But I made a run to the hardware store to get something, and I wore a mask just to be safe. It feels kind of weird, I gotta say. Yeah. Never in my life if I had to do that, but I did it just to be safe.
Let's see, I missed a homeschooling comment here.
Hey, Janelle from Texas. How y'all doing? Good
Mikey,
to have you.
Great. I'm teaching my little brother about gardening. That's wonderful. I'm so glad you're passing on your knowledge. John Marsden, this is awesome. Driving in the semi and listening to you. Wow, thank you very much. That's so cool.
Let's hear it from the truckers.
Lori Olson, I was already homeschooling my kids before coronavirus. My son and I started our seeds this past Wednesday. That's great, Lori. Way to go. Hopefully, I don't know how old your son is, but hopefully once he starts growing his own veggies, he's also going to start eating more of his own veggies too. A lot of times that happens. They get really excited about it and then they want to eat it themselves too.
Hey, Rock, we see your hi. We say hi back. Laura says the mask of her anxiety. I gotta admit, it felt weird to me too as well. So it took me a little bit to get used to it. But then when you see other people with their mask too, you're kind of like, okay, so it's not just me. But I feel you there, Lori. No worries there.
Not been into any stores. Like, I've been like ordering groceries online and everything. So I've pretty much been home and haven't tried to stay out of stores as much as I can. But it is kind of a strange feeling.
Yep.
Oh, Mauricio, I'm so sorry. I had my little veggies and a hailstorm totally killed them.
Oh my gosh.
That's so crushing. I'm so sorry to hear that.
Yeah, the battle is real.
Oh, it is real. And sometimes those challenges are so disappointing. So hopefully you're able to get some more started and get them going and still have some more time to plant. So really sorry to hear that.
Sorry. Bye, Mikey Cardenas. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time.
Luz, considering your beautiful and vast garden, what veggies do you find yourselves buying at the grocery store? Luz, actually right now, I'm really not buying any veggies at the grocery store aside from avocados. We're pretty much just eating salads and kale. I put a picture on my Instagram today of a beautiful tomato harvest that I did right behind me here from that tomato plant you guys saw on Monday's live stream. And then we're just pretty much eating salads from the garden right now and waiting for the more tomatoes. A few strawberries, that was really fun.
Yep, and peanut M&Ms. I'm just being real.
Peanut M&Ms too. And dark chocolate. I love, absolutely love dark chocolate. So dark chocolate and strawberries is a really good combination.
Deb Rich says her son has helped her a lot out in the garden with tilling and cattle panel trellises.
Oh, good.
Awesome. Way to go.
That's great. We love those cattle panel trellises.
Yes, we do.
From April Brian 74. Hi, you guys are great. Wow, thank you. My tomatoes have had flowers for a week, but no tomatoes on them. Is this normal? First time grower of tomatoes in Tampa. Yeah, I'd say that's very normal. Sometimes it takes a while, and especially in Tampa, I bet it's really hot there right now. And if you go back and watch our heat video we did this week, I talked about that a little bit, how in temperatures over 85 or 90 degrees Fahrenheit, production really slows down. Sometimes the flowers might dry up and drop off. And I talked about four tips you can do to help your vegetables not burn up in the heat. So go back and watch that video. And just stay patient because you're going to see some tomatoes really soon.
But watch for tomorrow morning too, because we're going to drop a video giving you an update of what Kim has covered with her shade cloths. So make sure you be watching for that one.
That's right. So that'll be out hopefully sometime in the morning tomorrow.
Guess what I'll be doing tonight.
It'll be a late night over here.
That's what I do.
Okay, let's see. Any other questions here in the chat? I did pull a couple of questions from some videos. I can always read those too if we don't have any questions here. Marie Heffman, tomatoes are ready. Yeah, I actually showed on Monday's live stream. There's a tomato plant right behind me that we overwintered. I planted it, I think, in August or September. We had warm weather all throughout the winter this year, no frost, and it actually survived, and it's now really picking up with the harvest. So pretty exciting to have some really early tomatoes.
Right on. Tonda Cooper got her smart pots today. She's excited to use them. Right on.
Yay.
You are absolutely going to love them. And just make sure you watch Kim's videos about container gardening. She just tells you all about them, little tricks and stuff here and there on them. You're going to absolutely love them. Keep us posted, Tonda. Way to go.
Do keep us posted. They do really well in the heat, too. Okay, oh, here's a great one from Marie Heffern. I convinced my husband to get rid of our curtains so I could use them for shade pop.
That's clever.
Yeah, who needs curtains anyway, right?
Overrated.
But you definitely need vegetables. So yeah, get rid of the curtains, throw them over your vegetables.
Yep, very good.
In the heat. Good idea. And good for
That's
your husband.
Funny. That's really funny.
Okay, oh, this is a great one. Shweta Singh, thank you so much. My toddlers also learned about good insects for the garden. Thank you so much. Kim. Oh, you're so welcome. How fun it is to learn about all these things with your kids. What a joy for them to learn at a young age to love to grow vegetables and all about the beneficial bugs. I want to tell you something. Go out in the garden with them when it's dark. Take a flashlight out. Remember we did that a couple times?
Yeah.
And looked for bugs on the plants to see if you can identify what's eating your plants, because a lot of times they come out at night, and I bet your kids will really have fun with that too.
Nicole was asking if tomorrow's video is going to be a coffee walk in the garden. No, it's not. It's going to be purely going to the shade class and seeing how they're doing. And we're actually going to show you what happens with the temperature when you go from outside in the, you know, open exposed air to under a shade cloth. You won't believe the jump.
Yeah,
so
that's crazy.
Don't miss that one.
Let's see.
I'm moving along here too. Oh, there's a lizard down there by my feet.
The naked gardener.
I'm ignoring the lizard by my feet right now.
Max chasing him too. What are your top three plants you must grow in the garden? That is such a hard one because I literally love just about every plant I have. Of course, tomatoes. I always have to have tomatoes. I like to try and grow different color tomatoes. I've got some yellow ones behind me. Got some purple ones planted. Some golden, big golden jubilee ones, like from my tomato seed collection, and those are probably one of my favorites. But I also love all kinds of flowers. I'd say the flowers and the edible flowers are great, like the nasturtiums, which we happen to have right here. But those are great because they're so beautiful. They bring in the pollinators like crazy. The third one would probably be, well, I always love my peppers. I've got a really nice pepper plant and a pepper coming on. Jerry, scooch over just a tad so they can see. A little pepper coming on right here. You guys see that? I don't remember the variety, but the peppers, just the beautiful colors, and we love to grill peppers too. It's one of our favorite things on the grill. So I could go on, but that's some of the top three.
Now, Missouri girl's getting personal here. She asked, Jerry, what did you do this week? Did Kim keep you busy? That's
that
really funny. And then she does an LOL. So that is really, really funny. And the answer is yes, she did keep us busy. And we had plenty to do this week. And I also just fixed a lot of little things here and there. So yeah, kept pretty busy that way.
It's nice to have the time for him to have the time to fix some stuff that we've been needing to fix for a long time.
Yeah, that's true.
And we're also keeping busy with the seed shop, filming videos. And our son, a senior, who is home now too, so he's been helping us do a lot of things around the Cali Kim business as well. So that's been really great to have them around. And we are adjusting to all three being home at the same time.
Yes.
About a month now, but you know, you adjust when you have to.
Now Jocelyn's asking a question. She's up in Seattle and she's saying, I'm growing some purple opal basil seedlings. Looks like one of my butter crunch lettuce snuck into the same pot. At what point do I need to separate them?
Ah, you know what? I don't even think I would separate them, Jocelyn. Just let them keep on growing. Actually, you can keep an eye on it. When they get like two or three sets of true leaves, and those are the leaves that'll actually start looking like a lettuce or a basil leaf, you could probably, I'm going to recant that just a little bit, you could probably kind of pull them apart and then transplant your lettuce into another pot, or just plant some more lettuce seeds in another pot too, so you'll have double the goodness. Great to hear from you, Jocelyn.
So I got a couple of people asking to see Drew again in front of the camera. And for those of you who go way, way back, you remember Drew did an appearance as the scientist guy. I think he was 10 or 9 or something. Well, he's 18 now. It's going to take a lot to get him onto a live stream or into a video, but we will definitely see what we can do. He is a really good looking kid, and he's just a great, great kid all the way around. I still call him kid.
Maybe
thanks for asking
about
Drew.
Maybe we could get him to come out on next Friday's
maybe we can.
Fireside chat for a little bit.
Right on.
Okay, Baltazar Morales. I also have a pepper that overwinters that already has a few peppers. Okay, that's really fun because you're going to get those really early peppers from any plants that you overwintered. And I think I've got a couple right back here that I did the same thing to. So yeah, that's great.
Yeah, don't forget, if you guys have a question, throw the word question in front of the sentence so we know right away that that's something we can find here in the chat. It's flying by here.
Okay. Hi, Missouri girl. How are you doing? Great to see you on here. Kim, so great that you have all that help now and to spend more time with the guys. Absolutely. Yeah, it is great.
Yeah, it's been fun.
I'm not so sure Drew's too happy about being home all the time, but yeah, he's had a great attitude and really jumped in to help us out. So it's really been wonderful.
Yeah, he's adjusting a little bit better. 3 weeks ago, I think, Cliff, you and I, we chatted back and forth about how your kid was also dealing with staying home. Drew's doing better. I think he's adjusting and it's kind of setting in a little bit more.
Okay, Abby Rucker, well, that's a good question. Do you have any ideas for careers related to gardening? I'm in high school, graduating next year, and gardening is something I'm passionate about.
Right on.
Well,
that's a great question.
That's a very good question. You could do like we did and start a YouTube channel and start sharing with other people on how to garden, teach people how to garden. Or you could also do garden consults with some of your friends. Maybe their parents need to know how to garden. I would totally soak up all the information that you can about gardening from YouTube videos, from books, from that kind of thing, and just learn as much as you can, have as much knowledge as you can. Go out there and do it, and then ask people if they need help in their gardens, and you never know where that might lead. So really good question, Abby. It's really a joy to share what you're passionate about with other people, so go for it. Okay, Janet O, Camera Guy and Callie Kim, our temperatures are in the 80s and 90s. Yeah, you're hot just like we are here. Patty, great comment. Help people make victory gardens. Absolutely. We've been talking a little bit on Instagram about the victory gardens, and they're really making a comeback. And for those of you that aren't familiar with that,
that was a
concept back in World War I and World War II, where people were encouraged, the government actually encouraged people to grow gardens as a source of food. And a lot of people really started doing that, and it's really coming back now. So many people are planting gardens, and basically the motto was plant seeds for victory. So we could even say that now, plant seeds for victory, empower yourself, take some action, and it really does feel good to know that you're growing your own healthy food that hasn't been touched by anyone else in the grocery store.
Now, have we done a video on that?
No, we're actually doing, gonna be doing a container garden series in a few weeks. So starting that in a few weeks. So we are gonna be tying the victory garden into that. So make sure you tune in and watch for those videos.
So it'd be like a victory container garden.
Yes.
Could be.
Gonna be growing in smart pots.
Simple.
And it's really easy. Anybody can do it. You don't even have to have a lot of space.
Right. All right, right on. That'll be something to look forward to.
Okay, Missouri girl, thank you so much. I know what you mean. My son Braden is a senior and he's not happy about the senior year without graduation and prom. Absolutely. We're getting ready for college if he can finish school classes.
Yeah,
I really feel for the seniors out there because Drew didn't know his last day of school was going to be his last day of school.
Yeah.
That he's never going back there. So it is really tough for the seniors. So yeah, I hear you. Definitely. Regina, welcome so much. First time I've ever caught you live. Well, I'm so glad that you're here, Regina. Thank you so much for joining us.
Hello, Terry from
Phoenix.
And
I hope you come back on Monday, too.
Sorry.
That's okay.
Terry from Phoenix, welcome. Good to have you. Phoenix is probably hot, right? You guys are always hot out there.
Oh, my goodness. Like. Phoenix, super hot. Gilda Molinar, will nasturtiums grow in the hot weather? They like the cool weather best. Temperatures under 80. So the nasturtiums back here are actually kind of struggling. I just took the shade cloth off as we came down for the live stream. And we'll show you that more on tomorrow's video. But those orange nasturtiums right over there are kind of getting fried. So it's a little bit sad. I mean, you do your best, to protect what you can. But the cool weather vegetables are just not going to stand up super well to the hot temperatures like we've had here. So plant them early in the spring. For those of you that live, in cooler climates, they'll do well. And then plant them in the shade in the summertime You won't get as many flowers, but you'll still get some growth out of them.
You're welcome, Laura. Thank you very much for that. And here's a cool one. Barbara Hinman says, hey guys, just started following you from Temecula. That's a really cool place. We need to get out there sometime and visit Temecula. I've heard a lot about it. We've driven in the area, but not exactly hung out in Temecula. Love the opportunity to dig into vegetable gardening. Right on. Love your practical take on gardening. Thank you. And thanks for helping us all through this. Right on.
Thank you.
You're very welcome. Great to have you here.
105 in Phoenix for next Wednesday.
Oh my goodness. I don't do
That's
105.
Crazy. Yeah, I don't even want to go outside when it's that.
Mic drop. I'm out.
Bye, Jerry. Any ideas to warm soil faster, easier for watermelon and squash? Okay, great question, Deb. I actually cover this in my book. I have a little section on how to warm your soil faster, a little tip. What I've done before, well, we don't need to do it too often here because it gets warm enough, but you can cover your soil with a piece, your garden bed, with a piece of plastic, black plastic, or even a white piece of plastic or a garbage bag or whatever, and just let it sit there for a couple of days. It's called solarizing your soil, and that'll just help the soil to warm up a little bit so you can get your squash plant a little bit sooner. So check my book out for some more tips on that.
Terry asks, do you keep chickens? There is nay a chicken on the property. It would be a can of worms, I think, if we brought in chickens.
Oh, I would love to, though.
I mean, their eggs are really good, but I don't know. I don't think we're allowed to.
No, actually we can, but I would love to. We just honestly have not had the time to put into that, but that would be a really fun future project. And I know a lot of you out there do have chickens, and we could use some help on that. So that would be really fun to do.
Connie Graham says the Victory Garden would be a great idea. She loves it. Anything positive is great right now. Couldn't agree with you more on that.
Absolutely.
Okay, so be watching for it then.
Okay. Nate and Carmen's Garden. What are you laughing at?
Yeah. Okay, I got it. Let me just interrupt you. Hold that spot. So Kathia wrote, hi, Kelly Kim and Camera Gut.
Hi, Kathia. How are you doing?
And then she wrote, Guy.
That's funny. We hope we're not getting guts here, you know, right?
Yeah.
Okay, Nate and Carmen's Garden. The bees came very late this year in the Bay Area. Did that happen in SoCal? No, it really didn't. In fact, right now the garden is covered in bees because we have so stinking many flowers. So I'm hoping that this hot weather, if it doesn't kill off all the nasturtiums, the bees will stick around. But I'm definitely getting some more warm weather flowers going. So hopefully you can plant more flowers and they'll come around your garden quite a bit.
Jack, that's funny.
Great question, Jack. Mm. How is the Maryland heat compared to the heat you get last year? Well, it's probably hotter than it was when we went to Maryland to see Gary at the Rusted Garden. Some of you might have seen those videos, but it's a dry heat here. So it doesn't feel near as hot. I know in Maryland, it's so hot and so humid. I think we were dripping with sweat every single minute we were there.
Yeah.
So Jack, I think you probably do have it worse than us. But, you know, here in April, we're nearly 100 degrees. So you don't get your heat till a little bit later in the year. So,
Kathia, we're good. No worries. All good.
Lindsay, I'm a first year gardener. That's great, Lindsay. And I'm so excited that you're gardening and here on the live stream. My strawberry plant leaves, even the new growth coming in, are turning black. Oh, no. Any idea what could be causing this? Also, thanks for the great information. Okay, Lindsay, it could be, I haven't seen that on my strawberries. It could be, maybe they do have some type of disease. I'm not familiar with that. I know they don't hold up too well to the heat. I've got my strawberries shaded, so I don't know what temperature it is. If it does get too cold, the strawberries are dormant. So it really just kind of depends on your weather. If you're just starting to warm up, you should be seeing new growth. But you may want to look into maybe look it up online and see if you can find some pictures and find out exactly what kind of disease might be going on. But if anyone has any suggestions for her, please pop some information in the chat there.
Fresh Landscape, thank you very much, man. I appreciate it. I feel you, brother. Thank you very much. I do consider myself the luckiest man in the world.
Well, thanks, honey. Nicole planted your sugar and peas today in pots to grow up on a homemade teepee trellis. Oh, how fun. I love those homemade teepee trellises. They're so cool to make out of tree branches. Excited to watch them climb. Yeah, it's really fun once you see them sprout. And they tend to just grab, if you kind of guide them up the trellis a little bit, they will tend to kind of wrap their way up. And we've been harvesting, remember all the peas we harvested earlier in the week?
Mm-hmm.
Picture on Instagram today on that, guys. But we harvested a huge basket of peas and we've been eating them. dipped in hummus for some healthy snacks, as opposed to the peanut M&Ms.
Yes, we have been having hummus and sugar snap peas and sambal. That something I grew up with. My parents, you know, enjoyed the spicy stuff from Indonesia, and I'm getting back into sambal now. And it really is really good with the sugar snap peas.
It's good. So tell us if you've had sambal before, because it is.
I think I'm saying
a lot of flavor.
It does add and a little kick to it too. Linda Brown, brand new viewer here from Fallbrook, California. Welcome. Good to have you. Yay! I'm glad you're here.
And Kathia, is it too late to start peas in Washington State? No, actually, I think right now would be a really good time to start peas in Washington. They're a cool weather vegetable. So what I always like to tell people is I try and give you general principles, and then you have to look at your weather and look at the weather that the vegetable grows best in, and then make your own decision. But peas do well in 75 degrees or under. And I have a whole section on cool weather vegetables in my book that you can take a look at. But I think now they would work very, very well in Washington.
Hey, the Naked Gardeners have a great question here. And I'm really curious to know this answer about you too.
Okay.
So here's the question. What is the one plant you have the worst luck with? That's a good one.
That's a really good one. And I have never had a lot of good luck with spinach. And broccoli, actually. I've grown it. I've tried it. I try it every year. But part of the problem is by the time it finally cools off enough here for it, grapes too. I haven't had good luck with grapes.
Yep.
By the time it finally cools off enough here for it, we have no sun in our backyard in the wintertime. And then once we get a lot of sun, it heats up like it is now, and the broccoli and the spinach bolt and go to seed, and I just have never gotten a really good crop of broccoli, cauliflower, or spinach.
I was wondering if anyone was going to say grape. Because we
grapes, yeah.
Have we ever harvested grapes?
We have, but
one time.
Not,
it's hit and miss. It's right over there. Not much to see.
The problem with grapes is we're doing so much with the vegetable garden, it gets eaten by the birds. Because by the time we get over to the grapes to take care of them, so one of these years we're gonna get it down. We'll just keep trying. Irene, okay, I'm glad that I'm not the only one that hasn't had luck with spinach. I think it seems like most people have one or two vegetables that they really struggle with. We all struggle with different things in the garden, and that's why we're here, so we can all learn from each other on how to grow different things.
That is a good question.
Okay, Keeper of the Random Pickle. Hi, just got on. love your channel. Oh, thank you so much. I'm so glad you're here. And I do want to welcome to anyone who's new, like Keeper of the Random Pickle, either on the live streams or new to our channel, new subscribers. Thank you guys so much. There's so much interest now in gardening. It's really fun to see all the comments and to see people who are loving growing their own vegetables. The excitement is really, really cool to see people growing for the very first time. So glad that you're here. Keep on growing. Stick with us. We have lots of great content yet to come.
I'll tell you what the excitement is. The excitement is, and I'm not used to this, is when Kim's prepping dinner and things like that, and she goes, oh, I'm going to go out back and get something. And she goes out to the backyard with a bowl, and she comes back with green stuff that she puts, you know, onto the eggs or things like that, and her tomatoes for the salad. That's crazy. The second crazy part is when we're out here, we'll just start snacking on stuff that's growing around. That's really cool, too.
That's
a blast.
Really fun,
so
huh?
Keep after it, everybody, so you can do that as well. Because it's pretty fun.
Backyard groceries. Nisha, how are you?
Yeah, and there's nothing like the taste of a backyard grown tomato.
Nothing like it. And I love to call it my garden grocery store. Mm-hmm. So thanks, Nisha, for bringing that up. And you've got your own backyard groceries right there where you live too. So here's a good question about lettuce from Pia Butter. When starting lettuce outdoors, how long does it take from seed to harvest? Compared from growing indoors under grow lights, lettuce planted outside, I notice tend to grow slower and leggy. So under grow lights inside, it's a controlled environment. You don't have bugs. Your temperature is very even and steady. You don't have cold nights that make it slow down. So it's definitely gonna grow faster under grow lights. That's actually a really good way to get lettuce and all kinds of seeds, vegetables started off to a really fast start is start them indoors. So lettuce, like back here, I planted some lettuce and it got really cold. So it took several months, I'd say maybe 2 or 3 months to grow. But under ideal conditions where it's around 75 degrees, 60 to 75 degrees, lettuce is gonna grow from seed to harvest in about 6 weeks. So once the temperatures get right, you're gonna be harvesting from your own garden grocery store before you know it.
So some of you are saying that we're buffering, so you may need to refresh your browser there so you can refresh the page.
That's
I just did, so
okay,
well, hopefully we're okay there.
Thank you so much, Rita Bonita. She said, let's see where'd her comment go. I lost it, but she was saying that she loves our channel and she's already learned a lot from us. So thank you so much. So glad that you're here and that you're growing your own vegetables.
Couple of questions asking if there's going to be another salsa garden video series.
You know, I don't have one planned, but if we have enough requests for it, we can sure do one.
Well, you got two.
So we got a salsa garden seed collection that you can pick up over on my website. And if we've got requests for it, we'll have to get some of those seeds going and plant a salsa garden. Maybe we'll do that as part of our, well, I'm not going to say that because we have other things planned for the container garden series, but we'll have to do that maybe this summer.
Hey, I'm going to say the name wrong. I apologize in advance. Christiana is also in Indonesia. Stay safe. Best gardener. Love your videos. Thank you very much.
Thank you
Good
so much.
Good to have you here too. One day I hope to visit.
Mark Gabriel Frades, may I ask if you can still grow tomatoes in a tropical 78 to 99 degrees Fahrenheit? And I would say yes, you can. You will want to watch our heat tips video this week because there are definitely things you can do to help protect your garden in the heat. And I know that we have a lot of gardeners that grow in, Australia, but Arizona, that keep their shade cloth. I don't know if Patricia is here today, but she keeps her shade cloth up all summer long and she grows a ton of vegetables. So yeah, you just really have to protect them from the heat and also grow some heat tolerant or more heat tolerant varieties. Just research those online and you'll find some that'll work well for you.
Vanessa also votes for another salsa garden series.
Ooh,
that's
okay.
Three votes.
Sounds like that might be coming up.
I think it's gonna get on the agenda here.
Okay.
Right on, thank you, Vanessa.
Let's see, when you're out of homemade compost, what do you use for compost? From Sally. Hi Sally, how's it going? You know what, some garden centers do carry compost, so you could grab a bag of that. If you're not able to source compost of your own or from a garden center, I would just use worm castings. Good Dirt also has a really good, besides their potting mix, they have a really good soil conditioner that's full of really good nutrients that you can add to your garden beds. Also water with worm tea, the Vermistera worm tea. If you don't have compost, there's lots of other good substitutes like that you can use. But start making your own. You can make your own, even in a small 5-gallon container in the matter of a couple of months. So get going on that and watch our video on how to make compost in a small 5-gallon container.
Hey, check this out, guys. We have someone from Australia on here with us, Katarina. Cool. Good to have you from down under. Everyone say hi to Katarina.
That's
right
great.
On. Good to have you. I don't know that we've had you on the live stream before. Welcome.
Welcome. From A. Gord, how to use the herb dill in your cooking. I actually am going to show some dill. I think we filmed today and I showed some dill. So dill, we pretty much eat fresh. We'll throw it in salads. It adds such a good flavor to salads. I wish I knew how to make really good canned dill pickles, but I've never been successful at that. And I just throw it in scrambled eggs. It's pretty much the main way that we eat it. But it does tend to bolt really fast here because we get really early hot weather, like right now. But the bees love it, so leave it into flour for the bees too.
Get more and more votes for the salsa.
Oh, okay.
So let's get that on the shoot list.
Seeds. We'll get on the shoot list. Okay, let's see here. Oh, wow. Lots of salsa garden comments here. 6 votes. Okay, any more? You see more questions there, Jerry?
No
scrolling
questions.
Through?
Falcon from Texas, thank Ooh. You for the love. Appreciate that.
Leanne Roos, wow, from South Africa. Thank
wow.
you so much. What time is it there in South Africa? And Leanne says, first time seeing your channel and love your garden and like your garden and your garden. Great. Thank you so much. Appreciate you being here. How fun.
This
love you guys
awesome.
From San Antonio, from Falcon. Okay.
Charlie from Wyoming, better late than never, right? Good to have you here, man.
Thanks for joining us. So I want to hear from you guys. What are you guys doing on a 3:04 a.m. in South Africa? Oh, my
wow.
goodness. Wow. Thank you so much. New
late
subscriber
nighter.
From the Philippines. Awesome. It's great to have an international community here. And just so you guys know, we do live stream also on Mondays at noon Pacific time.
Mm-hmm.
So usually on Mondays, what I do is pick some type of a garden topic and share, you know, some tips on growing that particular vegetable or composting or whatever that the case might be. So I do post those on YouTube as an event on Monday mornings. Yep. I also post a link on Instagram and Facebook. So come back and join us on Mondays. We'd love to have you and learn all about gardening together from not only myself, but also the community.
Yeah.
Here. It's wonderful.
We got people from London on here. This is cool. Mike Thank you. Talk to you later. Wear a hat and stay hydrated. Yeah, you got it. I'll do that next time. Lesson learned. Thank you. Appreciate it, man. See you next time.
Wonderful. Okay, Amber, in South Florida, the strawberries are rotting before they can get big enough and good enough to pick. Amber, I would imagine in South Florida, they are probably just frying in the heat right now. I really would recommend covering them with shade cloth, umbrella, whatever you can, because once it hits over 85, the strawberries just don't like it. They're not a hot weather plant. So give that a try and give them a good pruning. Even if you see the strawberries really dry up and really shrivel up, the strawberry plant that is, we've had some that almost looked like they were completely dead before, pruned back, gave them a good dose of the good dirt plant food and the Vermistera worm tea, gave them some compost, and they came back. So be patient, prune them back, and hopefully you'll get some strawberries out of them.
Hey, Cypress says she got her strawberry crate tower set up finally. Yay. The kids and I are very excited. That's really cool. That's a fun one right there.
A very fun one. And let me just turn the camera around here so you guys can see.
She's turning the camera.
It's always a chance when we move the phone here. So you guys can see the strawberry towers. It is such a fun way to grow strawberries. And if you're growing with kids, I know that they're going to love it too. So you can see that they are covered with shade cloth right now. And that white piece of material you use, there's Jerry running over there. That white piece of, thank you, Vanna White. The white piece of material is actually an old sheer curtain. So if you watched our video this week about heat, yes, you can see through it. It does allow a little bit of sunlight to come through. The shade cloth does as well. But those strawberries have already been picking some. Oh, those are little strawberries on there. I gotta come over and show you guys. They haven't fried in the heat, which is a really good sign. The shade cloth is really doing the job. So those will probably be ready to harvest in the next couple of weeks. There's a bunch more under there as well. So grow yourself a strawberry crate tower. Thanks, Jerry. Grow yourself a strawberry crate tower. You can grab the crates on Amazon. I think I probably have a link in some of my videos on that. And they're really inexpensive. Fill them with soil. Smart Pots has a crate liner, which is really cool. You just pop it in the crate. You can cut holes in it to put your strawberries through on the sides of the crate. And it's really a super easy way to get things set up. So yeah, get some strawberries going. Okay, let's see here.
Misha's waiting for her berries as well. Irene Moffitt.
It's hard to wait.
Picked some strawberries today. Nice. East Coast, nice. I believe, right, Irene?
So tasty, so fresh.
No, I keep saying that.
We had a few on our yogurt berry smoothie today.
Yes,
our
we
yogurt
did.
Berry little berry bowl that we made. Here's a question from Lori. Is it a good idea to put planted seeds outside in the planted seed trays outside in the sunlight or keep them under grow lights? Would it help them to get stronger by spending some time outdoors during the day? Okay, if you do that during the day, first of all, go back and watch our video on transitioning them to the outside. I give all kinds of easy steps on how to do that. You don't want to put them out for too long, too soon, because they're like little babies and they might die in the heat of the sun. So definitely do it gradually, but go back and watch that video so you know exactly what to do, because I don't want your seedlings to die on you. Okay, let's see here.
Erica gave us a $1 super chat. Thank you very much, Erica.
Thank you.
That is much appreciated. Thank you.
Katie Carroll, are those 5-gallon pots behind you with the tomato pots? Yes, they are. They are, can you scoot over just a little bit, Jerry? These are the smart pots. I carry these on my website, and they are great 5-gallon fabric pots that you can get a great start in. This is the Tiny Tim tomato plant, which I've got lots of green tomatoes on. I don't know if you guys can see that. A kale plant here, which we planted that on a video as well about a month ago, and the pepper plant. So I'm actually out of stock of the black smart pots right now. I should have some more in stock next Wednesday over at my website, CallieKimGardenAndHome.com, but I've got some purple ones there. So, but they're selling out so fast. So just check back maybe midweek if you want a black one, and hopefully you're able to grab one there.
Irene, as soon as I said that, I realized, oh, she's Central California, and Laura is East Coast, Laura.
Yes.
Montanano, I believe. So I get you two mixed up sometimes. Sorry about that. Hey, Charlie Benedict, thank you for a $1.99 super chat. Nice of you. Much appreciated.
Looks like we had from Johnny, a $4.99 super
chat. Oh, yeah, and Johnny Maserati.
Thank you, Johnny.
Right on,
appreciate
both
your support.
Of you. Thank you, guys.
So nice of you guys.
Yeah, that is really cool. It just floors me. Thank you.
Joanne bought 6 of the 5-gallon smart pots. Can't wait to get them. They are a great way to start, Joanne. Thank you so much for picking those up. And yeah, you are really, really gonna love them. You can move them in the house if it gets too hot. I moved our arugula in the house before the heat wave hit, and it's under a grow light inside for a couple days.
Laura, I'm just digging a hole. I'm going to stop trying to say your last name. Sorry about that.
Nisha, how is the passion fruit? I planted it at my friend's garden. Nisha actually sent me a passion fruit vine. It is growing like crazy. I need to transplant it. I'm trying to figure out where to put it in the garden, and I need to get a good trellis for it. So if you have any ideas, let me know. But that's really great that you're able to help your friend out with that too, and to help me out too. Thank you.
Nisha, I was scrubbing through old footage, and I came across you and Callie Kim meeting, out in Auburn, California.
Yeah,
that
was
so much fun. Yeah, that was just really fun. You have so much great energy and so bubbly and passionate about what you do. So thank you for that. That was great memories.
We loved meeting you and your husband. It was really fun.
Yep. Neville.
Okay, Fresh Landscape, how are your cucumber and watermelon seedlings? Will there be an update? We were just talking about that the other day, about doing an update video of some of the projects that we started over the past couple months.
Okay.
I can't believe how they are growing. I was gonna start hardening them off, but then the hot weather hit. They're right by the back slider door because I'm trying to get them a little bit of sunlight, pulled them out front of the grow lights. But yeah, we'll definitely do an update on that. Thank you so much for asking.
Well, Autumn says that Florida's having a heat wave too, Miami area. I didn't know that. I mean, you guys always seem warm to me, but I didn't realize it was a heat wave out there. So
wow.
Be careful out there too.
Rebecca, is it a good time to plant watermelon seeds right now in Wisconsin? Rebecca, watermelon really likes warm soil and warm temperatures. So I don't know what the weather's like in Wisconsin, but I would check your last frost date. And I think I have a link in the video description where you can find that. Look on Farmer's Almanac. You can type in your zip code and find that out. But you really want to plant watermelon even a few weeks after your last frost date. You can start seeds indoors about 2 to 3 weeks before your last frost date and then get them planted out in the garden. You'll have nice little transplants to put out once the weather warms up.
Hey, Michael out in Fort Collins, Colorado, college town out there. Thank you very much. Thank you for being here. I'm glad to hear you're enjoying the channel and stuff. We spent 10 years in Colorado ourselves in the Westminster area up there, and then we came back out to California. So yeah, we're feeling you there.
In fact, little note about Fort Collins, that's where my parents went to college and got married,
out there.
So yeah, it's a cool little town. We love
it. Yes, it is. I miss fly fishing in Colorado.
That's right.
I wasn't good and it wasn't pretty, but man, it was just fun to be out in the water.
You caught some fish.
All right, Michael.
Kristen. Hi, Kristen. How are you? Can you grow squash in a 5-gallon smart pot? I'm going to say, Kristen, it really depends on the variety of squash. In my squash seed collection, I have a smaller variety called, it's a scalloped squash. It's a beautiful, beautiful squash. That would probably work pretty well in the 5-gallon. A larger size squash like zucchini or the climbing squashes like the butternut or spaghetti squash, I would definitely do in a larger pot to get more production. I'd say maybe a 10 to 15, even a 20 gallon would be better for that.
You know, Michael in Fort Collins asked, can you put neem oil on things that you're going to eat?
You absolutely
can.
Absolutely. Yeah, it's an organic pesticide or fungicide. You can definitely put it on things that you eat. Maybe a couple more questions, and then we're actually going
to grill. I got nowhere to be tonight.
We're going to grill burgers tonight. So.
Oh, that's right.
Remember, starting up the grill after this. And I'm going to make some guacamole out of the avocados and throw some tomatoes in, too.
That sounds really good.
Unfortunately, my cilantro bolted, so won't be doing too much cilantro right now. But
I noticed there was some bolting going on.
All kinds of bolting, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, he knows all about bolting. Sure, Nisha, I'll pass some over to you. Sounds good, huh?
Oh, we got it. Turn the camera around real quick.
Oh, see Mac. Oh dear.
Well, so much for the surprise.
There we go. Oh, sorry.
There he is. Hey Mac. Everyone wants to say hi to you real quick, bud.
Can you say hi, Mac?
Sit down. Sit. Yeah, boy.
There we go.
Have a seat, bud. Oh, he's just sweetie. All right, sorry guys.
He's been chasing the lizards and having fun out here with us.
Leanne Ross asks, do you guys have Instagram? Yes, we do. We both do. Kim is CalliKim29 at Instagram, and I'm CalliCameraGuy at Instagram.
Yes.
So please, yeah, follow us. That'd be great.
Yeah, thanks for asking.
Love to have you. Maria Heffern, sorry about that. Thank you so much for another super chat of $2. Appreciate it. That's really awesome. Thank you.
Very cool.
Mac, Autumn says hi. Okay. He's looking. His ears are up. Thank you, Autumn. Deb says hi, Mac, as well. Yeah, he's looking. He's up. Braden says, hi, Mac.
Okay, Autumn, do you have citrus trees out there? We do. Yeah, in fact, we were just talking about that, right? We'll have to do a video because we do have a good harvest coming up from our citrus tree. I'm not going to tell you what kind.
Oh,
remember?
You mean?
Yes, that one.
Oh, I forgot we had that.
So we'll have to tell you, we'll have to do a video, a quick little video on that at some point in the next couple weeks because we do need to harvest that soon.
Yes, Deborah, Mac is a border collie cross. Yes, he is.
Braden, Mac. Okay, have you ever tried to go rhubarb from John? No, actually, as a kid, we grew a ton of rhubarb. You guys can read my how I started gardening in my book, Organic Gardening for Everyone. We grew rhubarb a ton, and I love the rhubarb pie. I need to grow some. I have not grown some here in my garden, so I need to grow that and make rhubarb pie to kind of remember my childhood.
All right, hello to Rosario, writing from Hawaii. Good to have you. Aloha. We have a lot of Hawaiians. One from Lanai, who's a regular on, and you, and some friends in Maui, I believe, so. Very
yeah,
cool.
Very
good to
cool.
have you.
Nice. Hopefully we'll get to go back to Hawaii someday.
Yes.
I think we will. Okay, from Rosario, thank you so much for your channel. This is Teresa, and I just started gardening this year, and thanks to your channel, I've grown my very first set of seeds. Wow, that is so much fun. And Rosario, Teresa, the excitement that you feel when you see that first little seed sprouting is just so much fun. They're like your little babies, if you're like me anyway. And I know I like to check on my a few times a day, and I'm sure you probably will get that excitement too.
Yeah, Irene says she loves Maui. So do we. Yeah, every time we go there, we discover something new that we've got to go back. We always discover it at the end of the vacation. And we're like, okay, we're going to go back up there, you know, next time we come out.
That's right.
Does that happen to anyone else? Just us. Right on, Leanne. Thanks for following us. We'll say hi to you online.
Okay, guys, I'm going to take one more question here, and then we'll sign off for the night. And make sure you check out our video in the morning and then Monday's live stream. Okay, let's see here. Hello from Philippines. Can you help me planting avocado? I have not grown avocado myself, but from what I've heard, and I want someone else to comment here on this too, you need to have two avocado trees for them to pollinate each other. And I think they do take quite a while to produce fruit, especially if you grow them from seed. Okay, guys, thank you so much for hanging out with us.
Yeah.
Join us again on Monday. Watch for our video tomorrow. And we'll probably be live streaming again next Friday. Hopefully it'll be a little bit cooler. Maybe we'll be able to get the fire on next Friday.
Right on. I do want to just respond here to Courtney. She says, love you, Kim and Jerry. So stoked when you got a handwritten note when you ordered with your order. Thank you so much. That's so caring. South Carolina, thank you. And I'm sorry, you are welcome and thank you. So thank you for taking the time to state that.
Mm-hmm. And this guy here has been writing some of those notes lately. So mm-hmm. if you order seeds from us, you might get a note from Camera Guy too.
Yep. If you make your order, request a note from Camera Guy or whatever my name is. I'll write something to you.
All right, guys. Cool. Have a great weekend.
Yeah, what a good time.
Thanks so much for hanging out.
Yep.
A great group tonight. Really appreciate hearing all your gardening tips and advice and encouragement to each other. It's encouraging to us too.
Yeah, listen, and just because we may not get to you on YouTube comments, we're doing our best. They just come in so fast that it's so hard to keep up with comments there.
Yes, definitely. And the same thing with emails, guys. It's really hard for us to get to all the emails.
Be patient.
So, please forgive us if we can't answer you back, but tune into our videos because we do try and answer the most frequently asked questions a lot of times in our videos or in the live streams. So
yeah, and
make sure
you
tune in.
And I think live streams are a good opportunity as well. You know, there's a good chance we can get your question then too.
Absolutely.
So
share it with a friend, and we will see you guys over the weekend
and
on Monday.
All right. Video drops tomorrow morning. We'll see you guys then.
Bye-bye.
Bye.